This is not a 3D model. It's a video footage tracking my mouse cursor in real time. It seamlessly blends three video files, center, left, and right, based entirely on where you hover. The crazy part? I don't know a thing about coding. I let Gemini build it, and so can you, from scratch or with my exact copy and paste source code to run this demo for free. So let me show you how I made it. So this is the demo, and here you can see that it actually follows where my cursor is moving. I know it's not perfect because it's still just a demo and I don't know a thing about coding, but it's pretty cool to showing ideas, presenting ideas, so someone more skilled with this domain can get better taste of what I want. So up, left, right, and you can do that too. It's pretty simple. I will share my code with you. You can find the code I get in the description, so you can try it for yourself. Only thing you need here is some assets that you need to upload so it can actually work, because I'm not hosting it anywhere on the web. So I prompted it to give me like upload option every single time I run this demo, call it a website. So my thinking was having videos of the same person, always starting from the same original image, and the last frame would be different Facebooks. If you want to get this prepared quickly, you can take a look at my other video where I talk about my free workflow that does this. And for this easy demo, I used only three directions. However, my idea was bolder because I wanted to have at least 9 poses there, so the logic would be way more complicated. However, the functionality would be basically the same. So the first clip is from center pose to looking left, then from center pose to looking right, and the last one, center pose to looking up. And now you can get more generated, like from side view to side up, from side view to side down. Logic is the same, but I didn't want to complicate it. Here, let's take a look again. One video, another video, another video. So my thinking was to have like one center frame for every video, and then this is the last frame for video 3, this is the last frame for video 1, and this is the last frame for video 2, and we have one video, then we have another video, and then we have a third one. Always starting from the initial position, and I just wanted to have a demo where the motion of my cursor is somehow linked to a playback time of that video. So I hope you get it from this professional chart. Now let's move to Gemini 3, where I actually made it happen. And it was a long conversation with the canvas turned on, where I only described what I want with my voice and my like visual understanding of things, and I led the heavy lifting for Gemini. So my first message was, I will give you videos of face where woman turns head. I wanted to react to mouse cursor, how to build it here as a demo. So yeah, I just asked it because I didn't know how to do that. It gave me some suggestions and built like the first demo. So it gave me some code, and I think that those first versions were completely unusable. It just got loaded, but then it stuck and it doesn't behave as I wanted. And every single time it like summarized what it did and what might be the problem, then it like provided me with some solutions, how to build a mouse following animation, which I actually don't want to build myself. I want visual demo. Can you build it if I provide video links? And he said yes. So I actually asked, how can I give you the videos? Because I have those on my desktop. And it told me to provide it with links. Then I gave it Google Drive links, which obviously don't work because I realized Google Drive is actually a website, not image itself. And then I learned that there is a hidden link for every image stored on Google Disk, and it can somehow retrieve it. So I used that version, but it was unstable. You can see it here. Those are IDs, and you can see those here. It somehow, based on my shared Google Drive link, it actually figured out its ID URL. I don't know how, but it just did. Then it worked somehow. So I continued. I don't see video frames at all, only black screen, as you can see. So this was what it gave me. I just replied, I don't want black screen. It did a check on itself, gave me some possible answers, then works now, but how to make it smoother. And then when the demo was kind of working, I started just to tweak it. Looks a bit smoother, but it won't reach end stage of each video, because when I was like moving cursor to the left and right, it just did like a part of the video and then it stuck. So I wrote it and he fixed it somehow. Then again, if it didn't work, I tried two adjustments that if I move cursor to left, it just out of place completely till the end. Again, it solved one problem but caused another one. So I realized then it needs to like also play in reverse because I need to get back to original frame. But introduce reverse play also. Now if I return cursor back, it just skips it. So I told it what it do and what's the problem. It built another demo. Again, it's lagging and it does not finish the clip. Can you give me some marker or joystick? There are typos, but you will excuse me. So it was a bit of back and forth until I reached out the stage where it actually looked kind of good. And then I basically asked it, okay, now it works, kind of. Suggest me what we can do here to make it even better. So it introduced like easing, and I also had idea to like zoom in when we are reaching end stage on each side and also above. Then it did the job, but somehow I ended up with like scaled down version, which I didn't like. So I provided a screenshot. This is what you are giving me, fix it. And it did, still not full screen. And you did not change UI as I prompted, because sometimes it doesn't listen, but just sometimes. In here, let's scroll down, perfect. Now, do not change functionality, it works perfect, because I want to make sure it doesn't introduce anything else and I wouldn't be able to like get back to my original version, which actually worked. From this point, it was only about like tweaking UI because I wanted it to feel like a website, so I placed in some logo buttons and I changed it for a like circular cursor, so it is a little bit more like eye-catchy. And with this version and somewhere in here within this long chat, I actually realized that those linked videos don't work. So in here you can see that if I go to my very last version, which is probably this one, hopefully, you can see that before the website will be loaded, I have upload buttons. So look left, select file, front to left, look up, front to up, look right, front to right, and initialize. I hope it's the last version. If not, I will find it somewhere. And now, yes, it's here. You can see it plays quite smooth. It was completely garbage in the beginning. In here, I indicated like a UI element that should show you can scroll down, but you cannot here. It's only this hero section. Move to left, move to right. If I do that, you can probably see there is some easing when I get back. And also in here, you can see it zooms in. When I go here, it zooms in. And it's just so fun to look at it and play with it, because with this tool, you can just create. And with all this, I am not saying it's replacing developers. Not at all, because this would probably never work in reality. There is so much more to get covered. So it's like fluent and it works on mobile and whatever else. But for me, this serves a purpose to visualize my idea and what I want somebody else to like help me build, or maybe to show a client this is the way of how this could be done. And it helps me to get way better feedback with it.